Yo, what's up, everybody? This is gonna be shelf number 3 of my DVD horror collection, so we might as well get right into this. Alrighty, so shelf 3 starts out with Lucio Fulci's Cat in the Brain. This was released by Grindhouse Releasings. Yeah, I don't know, a lot of people seem to kind of shit on this one a little bit. I really enjoy this one. I like the fact that Fulci plays himself, and there's good gore in this movie. I think it's fun. The Cavern, yet to watch that one. Cemetery Gates. Now, I've talked about this movie many times. I reviewed this on the Fright Tube. I recently put this in the Best of the Blind Buys too. If you've never seen either of those videos and you're watching this, check this out. This is a fantastic creature feature with just tons of really awesome kills, really high body count, fucking fun ass movie, man. Really highly recommend that one. Rupert Everett in Cemetery Man. If you follow my channel, you know I'm a really, really big fan of this movie. I love this movie. It's one of my favorite zombie films of all time, actually. Highly recommend that one. Has one of the weirdest endings ever. Stephen King's Cat's Eye, really cool anthology film. Kind of an overlooked one, or an underrated one, if you may will say. I don't know. For some reason, this one doesn't get mentioned a whole lot, but I think it's pretty cool. The Cell with Jennifer Lopez. Not a bad film. I actually kind of enjoy it. Central State Asylum for the Insane. This is kind of like a documentary style type film. I actually really didn't think this one was that good, to be honest. I thought it was kind of shitty. Georgie Scott in The Changeling. This movie just really, I mean, if you've never seen this movie, do yourself a favor, go out and watch this one. It's a really, really amazing ghost story. Creepy as hell. Fucking love that movie. Chain Letter. This is another one I've yet to watch, actually. Chainsaw Sally. This is the movie. I actually do prefer the TV series. The TV series, the first season at least, was released by Troma. If anybody knows out there where I can get my hands on season 2, because I don't even know if it was officially released or if it was, it like went out of print really fast, because I've never actually seen a copy. I've never seen anyone show it, and I've never actually seen one for sale, because every time I went to the website, it said it was coming sooner. I don't know, did it ever get released? But anyways, I loved the TV show. I thought it was fantastic. Really, really fun idea. Cheerleader Camp, released by Anchor Bay. Cheesy slasher film about cheerleaders getting killed at a camp. I enjoy this movie. I know some people don't like this one, but I think it's actually pretty good. Cheerleader Massacre, on the other hand. Now, this movie's a piece of shit. This was directed by Jim Woronowski. He also did movies like Chopping Mall. This is such a step down for him. It's such a fucking bad movie. Everything about this movie sucks. It's just a really bad slasher. Cello, part of the Tartan Asian Extreme line. I've yet to watch that one either. Cherry Falls, this is a UK import. I believe this movie is cut. I know there's fucking multiple editions of this movie, or different. I don't know. I think our edition of it is out of print. I think that's why I end up getting this one. You know, but for what it is, it's actually pretty enjoyable. It's got Jay Moore, Brittany Murphy. I actually kind of would recommend that movie. I thought it was pretty good. The Children, there's no way I paid $9.99 for this movie. But with that said, I really did enjoy this movie. I thought it was fantastic. If you've never seen The Children, check that one out. It's pretty cool. Children of the Corn, classic. Love that movie. Double pack of Children of the Corn 2 and 3. For some weird reason, I never got these solo-y. I don't know why. I actually kind of enjoy these movies, to be honest. Children of the Corn 3 is absolutely hilarious. It's so bad, it's just good. Children of the Corn 4, which I actually really do enjoy. I think this movie is really good. It stars, it's got Karen Black in it. And Naomi Watts, that's who I was trying to think of. Yeah, a young Naomi Watts is in that film. Part 5, Children of the Corn 5, this one has Eva Menendez in it. It's okay. It's better than this one. Children of the Corn 666, Isaac's Return. This movie sucks. Children of the Corn 7, Revelation. I haven't watched this one in a while. I don't really remember too well. And Children of the Corn Genesis, $14.99 used. Wow, there's no way. I think I paid like $2 for this. Yeah, not that good. Children Shouldn't Play with Dead Things. Classic Bob Clark. This is Bob Clark's first movie. He also did Black Christmas, among other amazing films. This is a really, really fucking cheesy, low-budget zombie film with a great atmosphere. The acting's bizarre in it. I highly recommend this one, though, man. I know Jason from Beyond the Realms just reviewed this on Cheap Ass Zombie Week. Go check out that review. Yeah, very cool film. Child's Play 1. Everyone knows that one. Child's Play 2, which is probably my favorite in the franchise. I really enjoy this one. I love the end to that movie. Child's Play 3, which I seem to hear a lot of people shit on, and I actually really enjoy it. I think it's actually absolutely hilarious when Chucky replaces the paintball bullets with real bullets, and the cadets start shooting each other. I think that's fucking funny as hell. A little morbid of me, but... Bride of Chucky, which I actually do enjoy. I think John Ritter's death in this movie is hilarious with the nails in the face. And Seed of Chucky, which is a terrible, terrible movie. But it does have a couple funny parts in it. But otherwise, this movie's really bad. Chillerama, a really cool New Age anthology film. Highly recommend this one. Choking Hazard. This is... I can't remember where this is from. It's a foreign film. It's like a Czech film or something like that. It's a zom comedy. It's a zom com, and I actually really enjoyed this one. I know some people have a hard time translating, you know, like foreign comedic, you know, punchlines and stuff. I fucking thought this movie was so funny and ridiculous. Maybe I was just in a good mood when I watched it, but whatever. Shopping Mall, classic. Love this movie. Everybody knows I love movies set in malls, and this is... just not the reason why, but this movie's cheesy fun. It's amazing. Linda Blair and the Chilling. This was released by Shriek Show. I believe it is like a Code Red disc, though. Yeah, Code Red disc. Whatever. Highly enjoy this one. It's about these, you know, these zombies, or these people that are put into these cryogenic vaults or whatever, and then there's a power out. I can't remember. No, they... Yeah, there's a power outage, so they put them out. I can't remember the whole storyline, but anyways, they end up coming back to life, I think, from like a lightning shock or something. And you got a zombie film. Highly enjoyable. I believe that movie's out of, or that disc is out of print now. Bloody Disgusting, Chop. Now, I fucking love this movie. I have never laughed so hard in my life at an ending of a film. I literally... was pissing myself laughing. My jaw dropped. It was so funny. Like, I just could not believe that that's what the whole movie was about. Highly recommend this one if you've never seen it. Loved it. Christine. John Carpenter's Christine. Classic. Christmas Evil. Some people shit on this one. I think it's fantastic. I love this movie. Citadel. I've yet to watch this one. It's on my watch list. I need to watch that one soon. City of Rots. You know, it's not that great. I thought the animation was a little shitty in this one. I know OD was telling me about that. And so I checked it out. And yeah, it's not overly that great. Chud, Cannibalistic Humanoid Underground Dwellers. Everybody knows this one. I think it's fantastic. Chud 2, Bud the Chud. Yeah, this movie was never meant to be Chud 2. That's why the storyline's so weird in it. But, you know, it's ridiculous, over the top, still very entertaining and fun. Class of 1999, very cool film. Clockwork Orange, classic. Cloverfield, I really enjoy this movie. I know a lot of people kind of get sick from the, you know, the fucking crazy camera work in this one, but I think that movie's really good. Club Dread, this is, you know, obviously a horror comedy done by Broken Lizard. This movie's funny as hell. I think it's great. The Collector, this movie is fantastic. I've yet to see The Collection, I know. Isn't that amazing? But, yeah, I gotta pick that up sometime. Cold Fish, now this movie right here is fantastic. This is a great, great movie. I think Danny reviewed this on the Fright Tube, and that was kind of what motivated me to check this out. And, yeah, really good. Highly recommend that one. Bloody Disgusting, and Slex actually puts out a lot of good movies. Cold Prey, love this film. I believe this is... Norwegian, I want to say. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I know there is a part 2 and 3 out. I need to pick those up. I heard part 2 is really good, so looking forward to checking that out. Colin, I have still yet to watch this one. I heard bad things about it. The Convent, love this movie. Great, great film. It's kind of like a Night of the Demons ripoff, but it's really well done. I really enjoyed this movie. It's fun. The Cook. Yeah, this movie was okay. It was okay. I didn't mind it. Cornered with Steve Guttenberg. This one takes place in like a corner store. It's a slasher film. And Yeah, you know what? It's not bad. It's not terrible. I had low expectations going into this. I thought it was going to be shit, but it was better. And I thought, Corpse Bride, love this movie. The Cottage. Now, here's one I don't hear talked about a whole lot. This is a really cool film, and there's a really awesome death with a decapitation in this film. I think it's awesome. Yeah, not bad, though. I kind of like it. David Cronenberg's Crash. I put this in the horror section because this has got to be one of the most bizarre storylines ever to a movie about people that get off on car crashes and death and stuff. It's fucking bizarre. James Spader and Holly Hunter. Fucking lots of nudity in this movie. The Crazies remake. At first, I did not like this movie. I watched it in the theater, did not enjoy it. Bought the DVD, of course, after it came out, watched it again, and did like it more. Crazy 8's actually one of my least favorite After Dark Horror Fest films. Did not really like this one that much. It's got Tracy Lords in it. She's actually not too bad in the film. Charles Band's The Creeps. This is a very fun film about, little people that are monsters. Yeah, it's a funny movie. It's okay. Creepies. Now, this is just a horrible, horrible, horrible movie. Until I looked up on the director and I found what he was all about, so I had to kind of recheck it out. This is actually really funny. It's just got lots of miniatures and blue screens and shit like that, and claim like really weird shit going on. It's actually not that bad if you take it for what it's worth. Creepshow, classic. Creepshow 2, classic. Critters, very, very fun film. Critters 2, me and JP were talking about this one being a little better than the first one, and I agree. Critters 3 with Leonardo DiCaprio. Yummy. just joking, guys. Yeah, Critters 3, actually not too bad. And Critters 4, for some reason I don't remember this one a whole lot being in space, but I don't know, it's weird. And here's a 4-pack of Critters. Crocodile, reviewed this on the Fright Tube. This movie's really, really bad. Really bad. This is Toby Hooper's Crocodile. You know what? Still yet to watch this one. Kronos, Del Toro. What year did this? I don't know. It was like early 93 or something like that, I want to say. Very cool vampire film. I really enjoy this. I think it's one of his better films, to be honest. Very different. Cool atmosphere. Love it. Crowley. Now, this one is written by Bruce Dickinson, and I gotta check this out. I have yet to watch this one, but it's on my watch list. I'm gonna be checking that one out soon. Might do a review on it. Cry Wolf, another one I find that some people shit on. I think this movie's highly enjoyable. I don't know, I take it for what it is. Cube, very, very cool film. I kind of sometimes think this is where Saw got the idea, or James Wan got the idea for Saw, but that's just me. If you've never seen this one, it's about some people that wake up in this cube kind of deal, and they have to find their way out, and of course there's traps and you know, all sorts of mazes and shit. This is a really fucking cool movie, man. Canadian, very cool. Cube 2, Hypercube, enjoyable. And Cube 0, I fucking don't remember this. I think this is a prequel. I don't know, I don't remember that movie too well. Cujo, the 25th anniversary edition. Cujo, everybody knows that movie. A bootleg of Curtains I got from the Horror Man. This is being released by Synapse on Blu-ray. Shit, man, I had a fucking boner when I heard that announcement. That's amazing. Another Canadian slasher film. The Curious Case of the Campus Corpse. This movie is fantastic, man. I really, really enjoyed this. Released by Shriek Show, I believe it is a Code Red disc. This is an Australian slasher called Cut, starring Molly Ringwald. Yeah. Very enjoyable. Very cool film. Cutthroat. I enjoyed this slasher film. It's a very low budget, just garbage kind of slasher, but it's very fun. Very fun. A lot better than I thought it was going to be. Cutting Glass, starring... Brad Pitt. You know what? This movie is actually pretty good. Cyrus, Mind of a Serial Killer, starring Daniel Harris. She plays, in Lance Hendrickson, she plays a reporter that's going to investigate the disappearance of, like, a couple hundred girls or something like that. And, yeah, it's actually pretty good. I enjoyed that movie. Stuart Gordon's Dagon. I gotta say, man, I might be in the minority here, but I'm not a big fan of this movie, to be honest. I find it boring and, like, weird. And I don't know, something about it. Dahmer vs. Gacy, hilarious. This movie, fucking so funny. I highly recommend this movie. It's funny. Dance of the Dead, underrated zombie film, Zomcom, very fun. The Dark Half, directed by George Romero, very underrated. I like that movie. Dark House, not the greatest. Has shitty effects. Jeffrey Combs is good in it, though. But, yeah, not the best. Dark Ride, I know some people didn't like this one. I really highly enjoyed this film. I thought it was a great slasher film. Dark Star, this is John Carpenter's first film. Very cool film. Dark Water, this is, the original Asian film. Very cool stuff. Dark Waters, I haven't watched this one in a long time. I got to rewatch this one. I actually don't remember too much. Darkness, this movie's okay. You know, I think I used to like it more than I do now. I'm not overly the hugest fan of it, but Anna Paquin's really good in this film. Darkness Falls, this is like the Tooth Fairy story. The end of this movie is just ridiculous. Darkness Tolls, this one has The Satanic Rites of Dracula, Horror Express, and Horror Hotel. Christopher Lee movies, actually all good movies. Dark Knight of the Scarecrow DVD, have this on Blu-ray also. Reviewed that on the 81 series recently. Classic. Dawn of the Dead, Divi Max. Another edition of Dawn of the Dead. And I just recently got another edition of Dawn of the Dead, which I was showing in an update, probably when I get back from my holidays. Dawn of the Dead remake. Dawn of the Mummy, I reviewed this one on the 81 series also. This is not bad. It's slow, but it's not too, too bad. Day of the Dead, classic. Day of the Dead remake. Really, Nick Cannon? Come on. Day of the Dead 2, Contagion. This movie's fucking horrible. Daywatch, I find this movie is amazing. So good. The Dead, this is a fantastic New Age zombie film. Absolutely love it. Dead Alive, you know, Peter Jackson's classic. Dead Birds, I've yet to watch that one. Dead and Breakfast is kind of like a fucking musical zombie film. Really enjoyed this, though. I thought it was fun as hell. Dead Cert, still yet to watch this one, too. Dead Clowns, not a very good movie at all. Pretty shitty. Dead End, I talked about this in a recent video. Awesome, awesome road horror film. Loved it. Dead End Driving, this is another Aussie film. Love it. Love that movie. Dead Girl, this is a fucked up zombie film about these kids that find this zombie girl in like this abandoned place, and they just proceed to fucking rape her. It's fucked up, man. Dead and Gone, this is actually a really, really low budget film. It's pretty fun, pretty cool zombie film. The Dead Hate the Living, I enjoyed this one, released by fucking Full Moon. Dead Heat, now this is just classic shit right here. Amazing, amazing film. The Soska Sisters, Dead Hooker in a Trunk. I enjoyed this film. I know some people are kind of on the fence with this one, but I really enjoyed it. Dead Meat, I've yet to watch that one. The Dead Next Door, low budget, fun zombie film from the late 80s. Love that movie. Dead of Night, now this is a Amicus anthology film. Awesome. Awesome shit, man. Everybody knows how much I like my Amicus stuff. The Dead Outside. This movie's not that great. But then you got The Dead Pit here. I love this movie. Now, this is a film that needs a fucking Blu-ray release, because this is one of my favorite zombie films of all time. Love that shit. David Cronenberg's Dead Ringers. Very weird film. More like psychological horror. Dead Silence. Creepy James Wong movie. It's good. I like it. It's very cool. Dead Snow, Norwegian Nazi zombie film. Awesome shit. And we got Dead Sushi here to end this. Sorry about this going on way too long. And speaking of Dead Sushi, I highly recommend this movie. It was fun as fuck. Just ridiculously over the top shit. But anyway, so that's going to be shelf number 3. Once again, I'm sorry for the length of this. I'm trying to get through these as fast as I can and just saying a little bit about each one. But I will be back with Shelf 4 sometime. Hope you enjoyed it. Leave comments. Peace out, brothers. Oh, believe it is a Code Red disc. This is an Australian slasher called Cut, starring Molly Ringwald. Yeah. Very enjoyable. Very cool film. Cutthroat, I enjoyed this slasher film. It's a very low budget, just garbage kind of slasher, but it's very fun. Very fun. A lot better than I thought it was going to be. Cutting Glass, starring... Brad Pitt. You know what? This movie is actually pretty good. Cyrus, Mind of a Serial Killer, starring Daniel Harris. She plays in Lance Hendrickson. She plays a reporter that's going to investigate the disappearance of like a couple hundred girls or something like that. And yeah, it's actually pretty good. I enjoyed that movie. Stuart Gordon's Dagon. I gotta say, man, I might be in the minority here, but I'm not a big fan of this movie, to be honest. I find it boring and like weird. And I don't know, something about it. Dahmer vs. Gacy, hilarious. This movie fucking so funny. I highly recommend this movie. It's funny. Dance of the Dead, underrated zombie film, Zomcom, very fun. The Dark Half, directed by George Romero, very underrated. I like that movie. Dark House, not the greatest, has shitty effects. Jeffrey Combs is good in it, though, but yeah, not the best. Dark Ride, I know some people didn't like this one. I really highly enjoyed this film. I thought it was a great slasher film. Dark Star, this is John Carpenter's first film. Very cool film. Dark Water, this is, the original Asian film. Very cool stuff. Dark Waters, I haven't watched this one in a long time. I got to rewatch this one. I actually don't remember too much. Darkness, this movie's okay. You know, I think I used to like it more than I do now. I'm not the hugest fan of it, but Anna Paquin's really good in this film. Darkness Falls, this is like the Tooth Fairy story. The end of this movie is just ridiculous. Darkness Tolls, this one has the Satanic Rites of Dracula, Horror Express, and Horror Hotel. Christopher Lee movies, actually all good movies. Dark Knight of the Scarecrow DVD, have this on Blu-ray also. Reviewed that on the 81 series recently. Classic. Dawn of the Dead, Divi Max. Another edition of Dawn of the Dead. And I just recently got another edition of Dawn of the Dead, which I was showing in an update, probably when I get back from my holidays. Dawn of the Dead remake. Dawn of the Mummy, I reviewed this one on the 81 series also. This is not bad. It's slow, but it's not too, too bad. Day of the Dead, classic. Day of the Dead remake. Really, Nick Cannon? Come on. Day of the Dead 2, Contagion. This movie's fucking horrible. Daywatch, I find this movie is amazing. So good. The Dead, this is a fantastic New Age zombie film. Absolutely love it. Dead Alive, you know, Peter Jackson's classic. Dead Birds, I've yet to watch that one. Dead and Breakfast is kind of like a fucking musical zombie film. Really enjoyed this, though. I thought it was fun as hell. Dead Cert, still yet to watch this one, too. Dead Clowns, not a very good movie at all. Pretty shitty. Dead End, David Cronenberg's Crash. I put this in the horror section because this has got to be one of the most bizarre storylines ever to a movie about people that get off on car crashes and death and stuff. It's fucking bizarre. James Spader and Holly Hunter. Fucking lots of nudity in this movie. The Crazies remake, at first I did not like this movie. I watched it in the theater, did not enjoy it. Bought the DVD, of course, after it came out, watched it again, and did like it more. Crazy 8's actually one of my least favorite After Dark Horror Fest films. Did not really like this one that much. It's got Tracy Lords in it. She's actually not too bad in the film. Charles Band's The Creeps, this is a very fun film about, little people that are monsters. Yeah, it's a funny movie. It's okay. Creepies. Now, this is just a horrible, horrible, horrible movie. Until I looked up on the director and I found what he was all about, so I had to kind of recheck it out. This is actually really funny. It's just got lots of miniatures and blue screens and shit like that, and claim like really weird shit going on. It's actually not that bad if you take it for what it's worth. Creepshow, classic. Creepshow 2, classic. Critters, very, very fun film. Critters 2. Me and JP were talking about this one being a little better than the first one, and I agree. Critters 3 with Leonardo DiCaprio. Yummy. just joking, guys. Critters 3, actually not too bad. And Critters 4, for some reason I don't remember this one a whole lot being in space, but I don't know, it's weird. And here's a 4-pack of Critters. Crocodile, reviewed this on the Fright Tube. This movie's really, really bad. Really bad. This is Toby Hooper's Crocodile. You know what? Still yet to watch this one. Kronos, Del Toro. What year did this? I don't know. It was like early 93 or something like that, I want to say. Very cool vampire film. I really enjoyed this. I think it's one of his better films, to be honest. Very different. Cool atmosphere. Love it. Crowley. Now, this one is written by Bruce Dickinson, and I got to check this out. I have yet to watch this one, but it's on my watch list. I'm going to be checking that one out soon. Might do a review on it. Cry Wolf, another one I find that some people shit on. I think this movie's highly enjoyable. I don't know. I take it for what it is. Cube, very, very cool film. I kind of sometimes think this is where Saw got the idea, or James Wan got the idea for Saw, but that's just me. If you've never seen this one, it's about some people that wake up in this cube kind of deal, and they have to find their way out, and of course there's traps and you know, all sorts of mazes and shit. This is a really fucking cool movie, man. Canadian, very cool. Cube 2, Hypercube, enjoyable. And Cube 0, I fucking don't remember this. I think this is a prequel. I don't know. I don't remember that movie too well. Cujo, the 25th anniversary edition. Yeah, Cujo, everybody knows that movie. A bootleg of Curtains I got from The Horror Man. This is being released by Synapse on Blu-ray. Shit, man, I had a fucking boner when I heard that announcement. That's amazing. Another Canadian slasher film. The Curious Case of the Campus Corpse. This movie is it's fantastic, man. I really, really enjoyed this. Released by Shriek Show. Yo, what's up, everybody? This is going to be shelf number 3 of my DVD horror collection, so we might as well get right into this. Alrighty, so shelf 3 starts out with Lucio Fulci's Cat in the Brain. This was released by Grindhouse Releasings. Yeah, I don't know, a lot of people seem to kind of shit on this one a little bit. I really enjoy this one. I like the fact that Fulci plays himself, and there's good gore in this movie. I think it's fun. The Cavern, yet to watch that one. Cemetery Gates. Now, I've talked about this movie many times. I reviewed this on the Fright Tube. I recently put this in the Best of the Blind Buys, too. If you've never seen either of those videos and you're watching this, check this out. This is a fantastic creature feature with just tons of really awesome kills, really high body count, fucking fun-ass movie, man. Really highly recommend that one. Rupert Everett in Cemetery Man. If you follow my channel, you know I'm a really, really big fan of this movie. I love this movie. It's one of my favorite zombie films of all time, actually. Highly recommend that one. Has one of the weirdest endings ever. Stephen King's Cat's Eye, really cool anthology film. Kind of an overlooked one, or an underrated one, if you may will say. I don't know. For some reason, this one doesn't get mentioned a whole lot, but I think it's pretty cool. The Cell with Jennifer Lopez. Not a bad film. I actually kind of enjoy it. Central State Asylum for the Insane. This is kind of like a documentary style type film. I actually really didn't think this one was that good, to be honest. I thought it was kind of shitty. Georgie Scott in The Changeling. This movie just really, I mean, if you've never seen this movie, do yourself a favor, go out and watch this one. It's a really, really amazing ghost story. Creepy as hell. Fucking love that movie. Chain Letter. This is another one I've yet to watch, actually. Chainsaw Sally. This is the movie. I actually do prefer the TV series. The TV series, the first season at least, was released by Troma. If anybody knows out there where I can get my hands on season 2, because I don't even know if it was officially released or if it was, it like went out of print really fast, because I've never actually seen a copy. I've never seen anyone show it, and I've never actually seen one for sale, because every time I went to the website, it said it was coming soon, or I don't know, did it ever get released? But anyways, I loved the TV show. I thought it was fantastic. Really, really fun idea. Cheerleader Camp, released by Anchor Bay. Cheesy slasher film about cheerleaders getting killed at a camp. I enjoy this movie. I know some people don't like this one, but I think it's actually pretty good. Cheerleader Massacre, on the other hand. Now, this movie's a piece of shit. This was directed by Jim Woronowski. He also did movies like Chopping Mall. This is such a step down for him. It's such a fucking bad movie. Everything about this movie sucks. It's just a really bad slasher. Cello, part of the Tartan Asian Extreme line. I've yet to watch that one either. Cherry Falls, this is a UK import. I believe this movie is cut. I know there's fucking multiple editions of this movie, or different. I don't know. I think our edition of it is out of print. I think that's why I ended up getting this one. You know, but for what it is, it's actually pretty enjoyable. It's got Jay Moore, Brittany Murphy. I actually kind of would recommend that movie. I thought it was pretty good. The Children. There's no way I paid $9.99 for this movie. But with that said, I really did enjoy this movie. I thought it was fantastic. If you've never seen The Children, check that one out. It's pretty cool. Children of the Corn, classic. Love that movie. Double pack of Children of the Corn 2 and 3. For some weird reason, I never got these solo-y. I don't know why. I actually kind of enjoy these movies, to be honest. Children of the Corn 3 is absolutely hilarious. It's so bad, it's just good. Children of the Corn 4, which I actually really do enjoy. I think this movie is really good. It stars, it's got Karen Black in it. And Naomi Watts, that's who I was trying to think of. Yeah, a young Naomi Watts is in that film. Part 5, Children of the Corn 5, this one has Eva Menendez in it. It's okay. It's better than this one. Children of the Corn 666, Isaac's Return. This movie sucks. Children of the Corn 7, Revelation. I haven't watched this one in a while. I don't really remember too well. And Children of the Corn Genesis, $14.99 used. Wow. There's no way. I think I paid like $2 for this. Yeah. Not that good. Children Shouldn't Play with Dead Things. Classic Bob Clark. This is Bob Clark's first movie. He also did Black Christmas, among other amazing films. This is a really, really fucking cheesy, low-budget zombie film with a great atmosphere. The acting's bizarre in it. I highly recommend this one, though, man. I know Jason from Beyond the Realms just reviewed this on Cheap Ass Zombie Week. Go check out that review. Yeah, very cool film. Child's Play 1. Everyone knows that one. Child's Play 2, which is probably my favorite in the franchise. I really enjoy this one. I love the end to that movie. Child's Play 3, which I seem to hear a lot of people shit on, and I actually really enjoy it. I think it's actually absolutely hilarious when Chucky replaces the paintball bullets with real bullets, and the cadets start shooting each other. I think that's fucking funny as hell. A little morbid of me, but... Bride of Chucky, which I actually do enjoy. I think John Ritter's death in this movie is hilarious with the nails in the face. And Seed of Chucky, which is a terrible, terrible movie. But it does have a couple funny parts in it. But otherwise, this movie is really bad. Chillerama, a really cool New Age anthology film. Highly recommend this one. Choking Hazard. This is... I can't remember where this is from. It is... It's a foreign film. I think I want to say, I think it's maybe, it's like a Czech film or something like that. It's a zom comedy. It's a zom com. And I actually really enjoyed this one. I know some people have a hard time translating, you know, like foreign comedic, you know, punchlines and stuff. I fucking thought this movie was so funny and ridiculous. Maybe I was just in a good mood when I watched it, but whatever. Shopping Mall, classic. Love this movie. Everybody knows I love movies set in malls. And this is... just not the reason why, but this movie's cheesy fun. It's amazing. Linda Blair and the Chilling. This was released by Shriek Show. I believe it is like a Code Red disc, though. Yeah, Code Red disc. Whatever. Highly enjoy this one. It's about these, you know, these zombies, or these people that are put into these cryogenic vaults or whatever, and then there's a power out. I can't remember. No, they... Yeah, there's a power outage, so they put them out. I can't remember the whole storyline, but anyways, they end up coming back to life, I think, from like a lightning shock or something. And you got a zombie film. Highly enjoyable. I believe that movie's out of, or that disc is out of print now. Bloody Disgusting Chop. Now, I fucking love this movie. I have never laughed so hard in my life at an ending of a film. I literally... was pissing myself laughing. My jaw dropped. It was so funny. Like, I just could not believe that that's what the whole movie was about. Highly recommend this one if you've never seen it. Loved it. Christine, John Carpenter's Christine, classic. Christmas Evil, some people shit on this one. I think it's fantastic. I love this movie. Citadel, I've yet to watch this one. It's just, it's on my watch list. I need to watch that one soon. City of Rots, you know, it's not that great. I thought the animation was a little shitty in this one. I know OD was telling me about that. And so I checked it out. And yeah, it's not overly that great. Chud, Cannibalistic Humanoid Underground Dwellers. Everybody knows this one. I think it's fantastic. Chud 2, Bud the Chud. Yeah, this movie was never meant to be Chud 2. That's why the storyline's so weird in it. But, you know, it's ridiculous, over the top, still very entertaining and fun. Class of 1999, very cool film. Clockwork Orange, classic. Cloverfield, I really enjoy this movie. I know a lot of people kind of get sick from the, you know, the fucking crazy camera work in this one, but I think that movie's really good. Club Dread. This is, you know, obviously a horror comedy done by Broken Lizard. This movie is funny as hell. I think it's great. The Collector. This movie is fantastic. I've yet to see The Collection. I know. Isn't that amazing? But yeah, I got to pick that up sometime. Cold Fish. Now, this movie right here is fantastic. This is a great, great movie. I think Danny reviewed this on the Fright Tube, and that was kind of what motivated me to check this out. And yeah, really good. Highly recommend that one. Bloody Disgusting Slex actually puts out a lot of good movies. Cold Prey. Love this film. I believe this is Norwegian, I want to say. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I know there is a part 2 and 3 out. I need to pick those up. I heard part 2 is really good, so looking forward to checking that out. Colin, I have still yet to watch this one. I heard bad things about it. The Convent, love this movie. Great, great film. It's kind of like a Night of the Demons ripoff, but it's really well done. I really enjoyed this movie. It's fun. The Cook. Yeah, this movie was okay. It was okay. I didn't mind it. Cornered with Steve Guttenberg. This one's takes place in like a corner store. It's a slasher film. And yeah, you know what? It's not bad. It's not terrible. I had low expectations going into this. I thought it was going to be shit, but it was better. And I thought Corpse Bride. Love this movie. The Cottage. Now, here's one I don't hear talked about a whole lot. This is a really cool film. And there's a really awesome death with a decapitation in this film. I think it's awesome. Yeah, not bad, though. I kind of like it.